Kurt Bühligen was a Luftwaffe wing commander and fighter ace of Nazi Germany during World War II. He was credited with 112 enemy aircraft shot down and over 700 combat missions. His victories were all claimed over the Western Front and included 14 four-engine bombers and 47 Supermarine Spitfire fighters. Born in Granschütz, Bühligen volunteered for military service in the Luftwaffe of Nazi Germany in 1936. Initially trained as an aircraft mechanic, after the outbreak of World War II, he was trained as a pilot. In June 1940, he was posted to Jagdgeschwader II Richthofen. He fought in the Battle of Britain and claimed his first aerial victory in that campaign on September 4, 1940. Promoted to an officer's rank, Bühligen was appointed squadron leader of the 4. Staffel of JG2 in April 1942. In November 1942, his unit was transferred to the Mediterranean and theater where he claimed his 50th aerial victory in February 1943. Back on the Channel front, he was appointed commander of the 2nd. Group of JG2 in April 1943. Following his 96th, Bühligen was awarded the Knight's Cross of the Iron Cross with oak leaves in March 1944. In April 1944, he replaced Kurt Ubben as commander of JG2. He claimed his 100th victory on June 7, 1944 and in August received the Knight's Cross of the Iron Cross with oak leaves and swords after 104 aerial victories. In May 1945, he was taken prisoner of war by Soviet forces and released in 1949. Bühligen then settled in Nida where he worked in automotive sales. He died on August 11, 1985 in Nida. Bühligen, the son of a pipefitter, was born on December 13, 1917 in Granschütz, in province of Saxony of the German Empire. He joined the military service of the Luftwaffe with Flieger Einsatzabteilung Oschatz on March 13, 1936. Following his recruit training, he served as an aircraft mechanic with Kampfschwader 153 from September 1937 to February 15, 1938. He then served as a mechanic with 2. Staffel of Kampfschwader 4 from February 16, 1938 to April 30, 1939. JG2 Richthofen insignia. World War II in Europe had begun on Friday, September 1, 1939 when German forces invaded Poland. Bühligen then trained as a pilot and was then posted to Jagdgeschwader II Richthofen, named after World War I fighter ace Manfred von Richthofen, as an Unteroffizier on June 15, 1940. There, he was assigned to the 2. Staffel, the 2nd Squadron of I Gruppe of JG2, which was equipped with the Messerschmitt Bf 109 fighter aircraft. At the time, 2. Staffel was under the command of Oberleutnant Karl-Heinz Graesert. On September 4, 1940, Bühligen claimed his first aerial victory, a Hawker Hurricane shot down over Dover. He was then transferred to 6. Staffel, a squadron of 2. Gruppe of JG2. There, Bühligen frequently flew his wingman to Graesert. Graesert had been placed in command of 2. Gruppe on 2nd of September. In September 1940, Bühligen claimed 3 aerial victories, a Hurricane on 11th of September and a Supermarine Spitfire fighter on 26th and 30th of September each. Following 3 further victories claimed in October, he was awarded the Iron Cross First Class on October 29, 1940. Bühligen claimed 1 further aerial victory on November 7, 1940, a hurricane southeast of the Isle of Wight, before he was transferred to 4. Staffel, also a squadron of 2. Gruppe. On June 18, 1941, 2. Gruppe moved from Beaumont-le-Roger to Abbeville-Drucket where it stayed for the next 6 months. From this point on, the Gruppe defended against the RAF Fighter Command non-stop offensive over France. In July and August 1941, while flying with 4. Staffel, Bühligen claims 7 Spitfires shot down, 1 on 7th of July, 2 on 10th of July, 1 on 11th of July, 2 on 23rd of July and another on 7th of August respectively. He then served with the stab of JG2 and claimed 6 further aerial victories in August and September 1941, 1 Hurricane and 5 Spitfires. 1 year after his first aerial victory, Bühligen was awarded the Knight's Cross of the Iron Cross on September 4, 1941. At the time he was credited with 21 aerial victories and 15 tethered balloons shot down. On January 1, 1942, Bühligen was promoted to Lieutenant. In March 1942, 2. Gruppe began converting to the Focke Wulf FW-190 radial engine fighter aircraft. Conversion training was done in a round-robin system, Staffel by Staffel, at the Le Bourget airfield near Paris. The conversion completed by end April. From then on, the Gruppe was equipped with the FW190 A2 and A3 variant. Bühligen was appointed Staffelkapitän of 4. Staffel of JG2 on August 1, 1942, thus succeeding Oberleutnant Jürgen Hepp, who was transferred. He claimed his first aerial victories as Staffelkapitän during the Dieppe raid on 19 August. That day, too, Gruppe claimed 26 aerial victories, including 4 Spitfires shot down by Bühligen, for the loss of 4 FW-190s. In early November, the Gruppe moved from Beaumont to Merville before ordered to relocate to the Mediterranean Theater. In early November 1942, the Western Allies launched Operation Torch, the Anglo-American invasion of French North Africa. On 17 November, 2. Gruppe of JG2 was withdrawn from the English Channel front and ordered to San Pietro Clarenza, Sicily. At the time, the Gruppe was equipped with the FW-190A3, some FW-190A2s, and received the A4 variant in early December. This made 2. Gruppe of JG2 the only FW-190-equipped fighter unit in the Mediterranean theater. The Gruppe flew its first missions on 19 November, securing German air and sea transportation to Tunis. That day, elements of 2. Gruppe began relocating to Bizerte airfield. Bühligen claimed his first aerial victory in this theater of operations on 3 December over a Spitfire south of Teberba 2. Gruppe area of operations in Tunisia. On 5 December, his acting Gruppenkommandeur Oberleutnant Adolf Dickfeld submitted Bühligen for preferential promotion to Oberleutnant. The nomination was reviewed by the commanding general of the 2nd Fliegerkorps General der Flieger Bruno Luerzer, headquartered at Taormina, Sicily, and by Feldmarschall Albert Kesselring, at the time a Oberbefehlshaber. Both Luerzer and Kesselring approved the nomination, leading to Bühligen's promotion on February 1, 1943. On 26 December, 18 Boeing B-17 Flying Fortress bombers of the United States Army Air Forces, escorted by 8 Lockheed P-38 Lightning fighters, attacked the harbor of Bizerte, destroying approximately 100 fuel barrels and damaged one cargo ship. 2. Gruppe intercepted the USAF formation on their return from the target area, claiming 3 P-38 fighters shot down, including 2 by Bühligen. In January 1943, the bulk of 2. Gruppe of JG2 was based at an airfield at Sidi Ahmed near Bizerte. On 4 January, 4. Staffel intercepted a formation of Douglas A-20 Havoc Boston bombers, escorted by Curtiss P-40 Warhawk fighters, on bombing mission to Fondauk, approximately 140 kilometers southeast of Bizerte. The bombers were already under attack by Bf-109s from a Gruppe of Jagdgeschwader 53 when 4. Staffel encountered the bombers west of Fondauk. In this encounter, Bühligen shot down a P-40 and a Boston, which he misidentified as a Martin B-26 Marauder bomber. On 7 January, 2. Gruppe moved to Kairouan airfield. The next day, 2. Gruppe flew numerous missions and claimed 12 aerial victories, including 3 P-38s shot down by Bühligen, for the loss of 2 FW-190s. One of the P-38s claimed by Bühligen was a 49th Fighter Squadron aircraft strafing tanks near Kairouan. On 14 January, he was credited with the destruction of another P-38. A flight of B-17's bombers, escorted by P-38s, had attacked the harbor of Susa. On 30 January, 5 FW-190s from 4. Staffel were scrambled at 7:30 to intercept a flight of 6 Spitfires spotted northwest of Kairouan. Shortly after takeoff, 4. Staffel intercepted the Spitfires and claimed 3 Spitfires shot down, including 2 by Bühligen, without loss. On 2 February, Bühligen became an ace in a day, claiming 3 P-40s, a Spitfire and a Bell P-39 Era Cobra in combat near Kairouan. Only one Spitfire was shot down on this day, and Bühligen, according to the claims list, was the only German to report one destroyed. No. 225 Squadron RAF lost Flying Officer SHA Short killed near Kasserine. 10 P-40s of the 33rd Fighter Group were lost, 8 from the 59th Fighter Squadron and 2 from the 60th Fighter Squadron. 5 American pilots were killed in action and 1 captured. German pilots claimed 13 Allied fighters, 11 were recorded lost in aerial combat. 2. Gruppe flew its last combat missions in North Africa on 11 and March 12, 1943. At the time, the Gruppe had 10 FW-190s remaining, 7 of which still serviceable. Bühligen claimed 3 aerial victories on 12 March, 2 P-38s and a B-17 near La Sabala airfield. On 18 March, the aircraft were handed over to 3. Gruppe Schnellkampfschwader 10. The pilots and ground personnel were flown to Sicily on 22nd of March. 2. Gruppe was then ordered to Beaumont-le-Roger, where they arrived on March 27, 1943 and equipped with the Bf-109G until mid-May, the Gruppe trained on this fighter aircraft. During this training period, Bühligen was promoted to Hauptmann on 1 May. The first operational missions following the relocation to France were flown on 13 May. On 15 May, 2. Gruppe defended against an attack on the airfield Pois Nord at Pois de Picardie. During this engagement, Bühligen claimed a North American P-51 Mustang shot down 30 km north-northwest of Berck. 2 days later, he claimed a Hawker Typhoon shot down north of Caen. Bühligen received the German Cross in Gold on June 25, 1943. Messerschmitt Bf-109 of JG-2, September 1943. On July 1, 1943, Bühligen was appointed Gruppenkommandeur of 2. Gruppe of JG-2. He replaced Hauptmann Erich Rüderfer in this capacity, who had been transferred to 4. Gruppe of Jagdgeschwader 54. That day, most of the air elements of 2. Gruppe relocated to Avrov-Fovel Air Base. On 4 July, Bühligen led 2. Gruppe against an attack by the United States Strategic Air Force's 8th Bomber Command, later renamed to 8th Air Force, on Nantes and Le Mans. The Gruppe claimed 3 B-17s and 5 escort fighters shot down for the loss of a Bf-109 shot down and 6 further damaged. Bühligen was credited with the destruction of a Spitfire and a Republic P-47 Thunderbolt in this engagement. On 14 July, Bühligen led 2. Gruppe in defense of an OSAF attack on the airfields at Villecublay and Le Bourget. That day, 2. Gruppe claimed 3 B-17s, 1 P-47 and 4 Spitfires, including one by Bühligen, destroyed for the loss of 2 Bf-109s and 1 further Bf-109 damaged. In early September 1943, Allied air operations under the deception Operation Starkey were very active. On 6 September, 2. Gruppe defended against OSAF heavy bombers attacking Stuttgart. That day, 2. Gruppe claimed 8 aerial victories, including 4 by Bühligen, for the loss of 3 Bf-109s lost. Bühligen was promoted to Major on January 1, 1944 and received the Knight's Cross of the Iron Cross with oak leaves on March 2, 1944. He was the 413th member of the German Armed Forces to be so honored, and at the time he was listed with 96 aerial victories. The presentation was made by Adolf Hitler at the Berghof, Hitler's residence in the Obersalzberg of the Bavarian Alps, on April 4, 1944. Among others, also present at the award ceremony were Hauptmann Hans-Joachim Jabs, Major Bernhard Jope, and Major Hans-Georg Batcher. On April 27, 1944, Major Kurt Uben Jeschwada, Commodore of JG-2, was killed in action. In consequence, Bühligen became the last Jeschwada Commodore of JG-2. On June 7, 1944, Bühligen shot down 2 Republic P-47 Thunderbolt in the vicinity of Caen, taking his total to 100 aerial victories. He was the 75th Luftwaffe pilot to achieve the century mark. Following his 104th aerial victory, Bühligen received the Knight's Cross of the Iron Cross with oak leaves and swords on August 14, 1944. He was the 88th member of the German Armed Forces to be so honored. On 1 October, Bühligen was promoted to Oberstleutnant. On December 5, 1944, Bühligen was briefed on the operational objectives of Operation Bodenplatte. An air superiority operation in support of the Battle of the Bulge launched on January 1, 1945. The meeting took place at the headquarters of 2. JAG Corps at Flemmersfeld. JG-2's main objective was St. Truiden Airfield, where it sustained heavy losses in the attack. Bühligen himself did not fly during Operation Bodenplatte. As Jeschwada Commodore, Bühligen was ordered to Berlin on January 22, 1945 and attended the meeting with Reichsmarschall Hermann Göring, which was later dubbed the Fighter Pilots Mutiny. This was an attempt to reinstate Generalleutnant Adolf Galland as General der Jagdflieger, who had been dismissed for outspokenness regarding the Oberkommando der Luftwaffe, and had been replaced by Oberst Gordon Gollub. The meeting was held at the Haus der Flieger in Berlin and was attended by a number of high-ranking fighter pilot leaders, which included Bühligen, Gunnar Lützow, Hannes Trotloft, Hermann Groff, Gerhard Michalski, Helmut Bennemann, Erich Lee, and Herbert Eilefeld, and their antagonist Göring, supported by his staff Bernd von Brauchitsch and Karl Koller. The fighter pilots, with Lützow taking the lead as spokesman, criticized Göring and made him personally responsible for the decisions taken, which effectively had led to the lost air war over Europe. During the final days of World War II in Europe, Bühligen led JG2 in operations against the Soviet advance on the Eastern Front. On 18 April, the remnants of JG2 moved to Cham. 2 days later, JG2 relocated to Berlin-Tempelhof Airport via Pilsen, where they refueled and moved on to Lech Airfield. From Lech, JG2 flew missions in support of the German forces fighting in the Battle of Berlin. At the time, Lech was under constant attack by the RAF. On 23 April, some elements of IN2 Gruppe, which were still based at Cham, surrendered to US forces. A few pilots managed to fly to Pocking before moving on to the area of Erding-Halskirchen-Preen. With 12 aircraft remaining, Bühligen disbanded JG2 on 30 April while parts of JG2 were dispersed in Lech and Fokking near Straubing. The last elements of JG2 surrendered to British forces on 8 May at Lech. An engine failure caused Bühligen to be taken prisoner by the Soviets, being finally released in 1950. He shot down some 112 enemy aircraft in over 700 operations, becoming the fourth highest Luftwaffe scorer against the Western Allies. All his victories were claimed over the Western Front and North Africa and included 47 Spitfires and 46 United States Army Air Forces victims, 13 P-38, 9 P-47, 7 U.S.-operated Spitfires and 14 four-engine bombers. He was never shot down but had to make emergency landings on 3 occasions. His final command was Jeschwada Commodore of the JG2 Fighter Wing. In December 1949, Bühligen was released from captivity and returned to West Germany. He settled in Nida, Hesse, where he ran 2 car dealerships. Bühligen died on August 11, 1985 and was buried at the city cemetery at Nida in Section D, Grave 42. Matthews and Foreman, authors of Luftwaffe Aces, Biographies and Victory Claims, researched the German Federal Archives and found records for more than 99 aerial victory claims, plus 9 further unconfirmed claims. All of his victories were claimed on the Western Front and include 13 four-engine bombers. Victory claims were logged to a map reference, for example PQ-05-OST-1157. The Luftwaffe grid map covered all of Europe, Western Russia and North Africa and was composed of rectangles measuring 15 minutes of latitude by 30 minutes of longitude, an area of about 360 square miles. These sectors were then subdivided into 36 smaller units to give a location area 3 times 4 kilometers in size. Thanks for watching.